Hello, hello, Marco. Welcome, and welcome everybody else. You are early to the party, my friend. Hold up, let me pop myself in here, shall we? Also, there's too much going on at once. All right, let's see what we got. Ta-da! How you doing? It's good to be back in the seat on a Wednesday night, or whatever time it is there for you. I'm DG Tinderbox, and man, do I have something weird in store today. Yes, indeed. This is my first time, technically, not counting yesterday. So I'll get into that right now, as a matter of fact. Let me just make sure real quick that my audio is good. Hang on, I'm going to fix that a little. All right, how is the how's this music in the background? Is that like completely drowning me out, or does it sound all right? That should be good. It certainly looks good on my end. So yeah, basically what happened is this. Yesterday was my very first. Audio's good? Rock on. So yeah, yesterday was the very first time that I've ever played it. Unfortunately, there were some issues with my computer, with connection, and the VOD did not survive. Lower the music a little bit? Sure thing. That's fine by me, because this shit was stuck in my head all night long. Here we go. So I played a little bit of it, and what happened... how's the music, by the way, now? Is that better? It sounds alright here. But yeah, so I had... like I was saying, I'd never played it. Back in the day when it first came out, I heard all sorts of things about it, and like people were chatting. I didn't ever hear anything like about what's in it. I just heard it was really like sensitive topics and scary. People were playing it scary times. Better? All right, right on. So I, as a matter of fact, the Game Grumps YouTubers, these big YouTubers, you might have heard of. They played it, and at the time I watched, I think, like the first two episodes of it, and I was like, yeah, this ain't for me. this ain't for Tinderbox. Not really knowing what was in it. So I paid it no mind, because, you know, some of those games that get big, the ones that become a fad, you know, they tend to be, like, they're not splendid. So I didn't do anything about it. Years go by, every now and then I hear somebody mention Doki Doki. I do know about the Just Monica thing. I don't know what it means, but I know everybody talks about it. And then a couple days ago, I was shopping for Christmas stuff at GameStop, and there's a copy of Doki Doki sitting on the PS5 shelf. So I was like, all right, so this is not your average fad game. There's something to this shit. So I downloaded it yesterday, and I played, like, maybe, I don't know, like, an hour and a half of it. So far, it just seems like a dating sim. I know it's gotta be different. So I hop back into it. I'm curious. But no, everything that I'm gonna be seeing, it's gonna be the first time I've seen it. Have you played it before, Marco? And, as long as we're talking about it, why don't I do a little, vwomp. Oh, it's not there. Hold up. Now it's there. Look at that. I was having some issues. This is the same thing. The same issue that I had with full screen ended up making it so that it didn't capture properly on the VOD. But, as you can see by this bright-ass anime girl thing here, it's working now. You'd played it? Yeah, fucking everybody else had. This my trusty Jurassic Park hat's coming off. So you can see my baldingness. It's a good experience to play for the first time. So far, it's been weird. Like, I don't know. I haven't really played any dating sims before, so I didn't really know what to expect. And thus far, it is, you know, it's not scary. I have to assume that's going to change, just because people have sung praises about this game for quite some time. So we're gonna hop back in. Let's see. 21 minutes, that's it? That's it? That's all I played of this? Alright, I mean, there you go then. Holy crap. Felt like a hell of a lot longer than that. So I'm gonna give it another shot. Yeah, I mean, I'm not gonna lie, like, I didn't expect it to, like, I was playing it for a while yesterday and nothing was happening. But I'm back. So we're gonna hop in the driver's seat with our girls. Hold up. Hang on, how do I go back? We got Sayori. We got Yuri. We got Natsuki. And of course, we've got just Monica. Oh my god, what am I... Alright, we're in. We're gonna keep going. Alright, let me just go ahead and make sure my levels stay... Ah! See, that's the issue with the capture I was talking about. I'm gonna have to get that under control. I can't click anything off of that screen or else all hell breaks loose. It's like 2 hours of the game, nothing specially happens, but it gets better. Alright, that makes me feel better. And don't spoil me. The reason that I've decided to pick this up was because, like, so many people did it, and I feel like I was able to, I mean, not that I was trying, but I sort of avoided exposure, so that's what we're in for. Might as well hop right in, shall we? Yeah, I usually, damn it. See, it's gonna take so long to get used to that. I usually stream Thursdays, Sundays. So this was, this and yesterday was sort of an impromptu thing. But, you know, felt like it'd be a good thing. So, you know, who knows how the turnout will be, but it's good to have you here, Marco. Let's see what we got. Alrighty. Boom, you can use the skip. Who should I show my poem to first? Hang on. I need help here. I need a little refresher here. Doesn't avert her gaze. I notice her chest falling and rising to the rhythm of her breaths. You were just helping. I shouldn't have done that. Oh, that's right. So I am in the story a bit of a ways. If you played it, you probably know too, but essentially I have just, I was hanging out with Yuri. Yuri's my girl. I'm full on board. Natsuki? You want me to start with her? I was doing Yuri. And I popped a chocolate in her mouth and she freaked out. That's right. Alright, we'll start with Natsuki this time. Even though she's a character. I'll even pop a voice on for you. Well, I can admit that it's better than the I can admit that it's better than the last one. It's fine, man. Go get some sleep. I'm gonna make an ass of myself here for a little while. But yeah, if you are interested, hey, welcome aboard. Thanks for the follow, my friend. I do Thursdays, Saturdays at least. So it'd be cool to see you stop by, man. But have a good night either way. Right on. Alright, may as well hop back into this, huh? Alright, well, I guess we're going with Natsuki now. I can admit that it's better than the last one. It's nice to see that you're putting in some effort. That's good. For those of you who do not know what the hell's going on, hang on, I'll give you a crash course, alright? So, like I was saying, I jumped into this game never having done a dating sim, but this is what I've gathered. So I'm a dude who has a longtime best friend named Sayori. You'll see her. She's got a big old bow in her hair. And she she was a member of this literature club. It's four girls. And she was like, you gotta come check it out. Just to say hi. And I come in and they guilt me into joining. So I joined. And the girls are all kind of macking on old Tinderbox a little bit. A little bit. And I have had to write some poems where you basically figure out who you're gonna go after. God, that makes that sound a hell of a lot creepier than I meant for it to. Fucking, wow. But, whoop, damn it. See, there it goes again. But yeah, for Yuri, the purple-haired girl, you'll see her, was the one I was going after, but here we go. And, she still hates it. It's trying too hard to be serious. It's because I wanted to be for the purple girl, you clown! What do you mean by that? Poems don't need to be all deep sounding to express something. It's just gonna sound like you're forcing it unless you really don't suck at it. Honestly, don't bother trying to write poems like this until you're on Yuri's level. Fucking excuse me. Natsuki stopped short all of a sudden. Don't tell me. Eh? You're not just trying to impress Yuri, are you? I shouldn't have listened to Marco, damn it. Everything's ruined. What are you talking about? And keep your voice down. You know Yuri would love this kind of... this angsty... I shouldn't have given her the angsty voice then. Just because she's a talented writer doesn't mean... I mean... Ooh! Looks like I'm in trouble. God damn it. The first choice of the game. And I listened to Marco. I don't regret anything. I regret nothing. I somehow struck a nerve, though. What I did is beyond me. I am so done with you. Natsuki shoves the poem I handed back over me. Take your stupid poem. If you wrote for someone else, just don't show it to me. Ouch. This is what I get for letting a younger girl step into my business. Unless I was a mind reader, I was destined to be in a world of pain from the start. At least Natsuki wasn't really the girl I was trying to impress in the first place. Oh, thank God. The game knew. All right. On that note, let's get back home. Son of a bitch, I need to stop doing that. It's the only game that does this, but I can't full screen on the screen you're looking at. So I had to do some old tinderbox wizardry to get it there. But every time, the consequence is every time I click away, it quits. It's like, nope. All right. What was the voice I gave her? It was like, so like, let's see what you've written for today. It's like that. Yuri stares at the poem with a surprised expression on her face. Do you like it? DG, this one might be even better than yesterday's. How did you even pick this up so quickly? Just yesterday, I was telling you the kind of techniques worth practicing. Well, maybe that's why. You did a good job explaining. Yeah. I really want to try giving it more imagery. Yuri visibly swallows. Even her hands appear sweaty. Mom's spaghetti. I'm not used to this. Used to what? I don't know. It's fine. Take your time. Yuri breathes and collects her thoughts. I know that Yuri likes to think before she speaks, so I offer that patience to her. She's super, like, timid, I learned. Yeah, just being appreciated like this, I guess. It probably sounds really stupid, but seeing someone motivated by my writing, it just makes me really happy. You saying you've never shared your writing before? Yuri nods. Really? I don't believe it. I really only write for myself. And besides, people would just laugh at me. You really think that? Again, Yuri nods. Huh. Oh, I mentioned this too. Animu! Hello! Welcome to the stream again. DG Tinderbox, do I know much about Doki Doki? Practically nothing. I was saying, so I played yesterday for the first time. I started it. And, lost the VOD. There were some issues with connection. Lost the VOD. But before this, the only thing I really knew was, like, it's a scary, like there's sensitive content, which, by the way, just as a heads up, there is, like, sensitive, like, if you, it said at the beginning, like, a warning, if you have a history of depression or something, just be careful. And that it's scary, and then obviously some of the memes, like, I know about Just Monica. I don't know what it is, but I know everyone fucking says it. Just Monica. That's it, man. I never really paid attention to it when it came out, just because, like, dating sims aren't really my game. They aren't my cup of tea. But, like, I saw it on the shelf at GameStop when I was doing some Christmas shopping. I saw it on the PS5 shelf. So I was like, all right, there's more to this than I thought. So here I am. But yes, this is indeed a blind playthrough. And so far, it's a fucking dating sim, man. I know something's gotta be coming. Something's coming. But, yeah. Here we are. Oh, crap. I have minimized the window. Let me unminimize the window. The window is unminimized. You thought this was a free-to-play game? Yeah! Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Oh, there was like a $30 version on Steam when I got this. So I don't know if there's like a, I don't know, like a DLC, but I didn't need that. I'm in this for the base experience here. But yeah, it was on PS5. That's why I'm here. And I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm invested. Like these characters are interesting. Have you ever played it? Do you know what's going on? Because it's not that complicated. It's just me and four girls in a literature club, and they're all macking on old Tinderbox a little bit. Even your close friends. Yuri here doesn't know how to share her poems with people. You've seen a whole playthrough? Okay. Yeah, I'm going after Yuri here. Yuri's my girl. I like this purple-haired Aphrodite in front of me here. This 2D beauty. You have the patience. Yeah, I mean, it's definitely fucking... You're telling me, man, like, all yesterday, like, my voice was starting to go. I was yawning from lack of oxygen. But I'm convinced. I need to know what the hype's about, man. So here I am. Yuri doesn't respond to that. I wonder why. Anyway, you want to share the poem you wrote today? Yeah, I do. If it's... with you. She's fucking... I told you, she's macking on me. We have a poem here. So they've already shown me a poem or two. And this is what we got here. This one's apparently entitled The Raccoon. The raccoon. It happened in the dead of night while I was slicing bread for a guilty snack. My attention was caught by the scuttering of a raccoon outside my window. That was, I believe, the first time I noticed my strange tendencies as an unordinary human. I gave the raccoon a piece of bread, my subconscious well aware of the consequences, well aware that the raccoon that is fed will always come back for more. The enticing beauty of my cutting knife was the symptom, the bread, my hungry curiosity, the raccoon, an urge. The oh my god, man. The moon increments its phase and reflects that much more light coming off my cutting knife. The very same light glistens in my eyes. My raccoon friend slices the bread fresh and soft. The raccoon becomes excited. Or perhaps it's merely I'm merely projecting my moment emotions onto the newly satisfied animal. The raccoon has taken to following me. You could say that we've gotten quite used to each other. The raccoon becomes hungry more and more frequently, so my bread is always handy. Every time I brandish my cutting knife, the raccoon shows me its excitement. A rush of blood. Classic Pavlovian conditioning. I slice the bread. And I feed myself again. I'm sorry. Oh, God. Well, interesting, Yuri. Very interesting. Yeah, anymore, I played through a good bit of it yesterday, and it's a slow starter. That is for sure. I know what you mean. But, like I said, I'm curious. I was a little more daring with this one than yesterday's. I can see that. It's a lot more metaphorical. I don't know if it's my fault, but I can't begin to imagine what this poem's about. That's right. It's a bit closer to my preferred writing style, using the poem as a canvas to express vivid imagery and conveying emotions through them. Yeah. If I take it at face value, then I can't even figure out what it's supposed to mean. It's almost like it's fucking... I'm not exactly a poetry man either. I tried back in, like, I don't know, middle school, but it was awful. The result was not splendid. All right, hang on. It's going to vanish one more time. Got to check something. Okay. How are the levels there? They look good over here, but can you hear me over the music, or is the music too quiet? It should be aight. It should be okay. Well, I think it's something that different people can relate to in their own way. I wanted to express the way it feels for me to indulge in my more unusual hobbies. Audio is good, right on. Yeah, Yuri is like the dark, sort of like emotional, angsty girl. So, yeah, I've been after her. There's like segments where you can, I don't know if you remember, where you can like choose words to make a poem. And I've been picking Yuri words. Before you came in, one of the other chatters, Marco, he had to leave, but he had me picking Natsuki, and she almost kicked my ass. It's those sort of things I'm usually forced to keep to myself. so I sometimes enjoy writing about them.
Why do you keep them to yourself?
Because they're embarrassing, and people would make fun of me. Do you have anything like that, DG?
Well, yeah, I guess I do.
I feel like everyone has a little something like that. The best we can do is respect each other and our individualities, even if it's difficult sometimes and some things make us uncomfortable. After all, I hadn't learned to embrace my own weirdness. I would probably hate myself.
I might be ranting a little bit. Yeah, a little bit there, Yuri.
But I'm glad you're a good listener.
I mean, I'm also the one saying it, so.
You're good at a lot of things. Writing, listening, sex. There are really not aren't many people like you, DG.
That's exaggerating a little bit.
It's just how I feel. I never thought I'd feel so comfortable sharing my writings, but now I almost feel like I look forward to it. It's just a really nice feeling. And you're to thank for that.
It's nothing, really.
Oh wait, where's my, hang on, I need my trusty Jurassic Park hat again.
Hey!
So emotional. So angsty. So,
fine.
Stupid. Yuri smiles sincerely at me. For just a moment, her timidness seems to disappear.
Yeah, man, this is interesting. I'll give it that. I'm on board. I'm interested in what this is doing, but
I hope it does it soon.
Let's go to Monica. I like Monica too. It's either her or Yuri. But the last one, like, she didn't pop up on the bouncy screen, so I don't know.
Hi again, DG. How's the writing going?
All right, I guess.
I'll take that. As long as it's not going bad, I'm happy that you're applying yourself. Maybe soon you'll come up with a masterpiece.
I doubt it. Yeah, I wouldn't count on that.
You never know. Want to share what you wrote for today?
Sure, here you go. I give my poem to Monica. It's like 20 words that are like completely unrelated to each other.
Dot, dot, dot. All right, this one's good. It feels like you're not only getting more comfortable with your own style, but the imagery is better than the last one I read. Just wondering, but have you been finding inspiration on Yuri's writing style?
Fuck, they know I'm a ripoff. They know I'm a fraud, man. I guess so. You can't deny that she's talented.
Yeah, totally.
What's this like? Yeah, it's like this.
I think her poems are the most romantic.
And now I have to delete this VOD too.
Uh-oh. That's the best way to describe it. She's like a totally different person when she picks up a pen.
I noticed that too. Or when she's talking about literature, it's like a light turns on inside her.
Mm-hmm. Sadly, it's hard to get much personal conversation out of her. Trust me, I've tried. Who knows what goes on in that head of hers?
I hope you didn't mean that in a bad way.
No, of course not.
Oh, she's jelly. She's jelly of Tinderbox, I believe.
I just meant that I wish she didn't keep to herself so much. But still, defending her like that, you must be pretty into her.
Oh. She's catching on here.
But I kinda like Monica too.
Eh? You completely misunderstood.
Calm down, I'm kidding. Besides, I'm pretty sure she's already got a boyfriend.
Ow!
Well, I guess I'm going after Monica then.
This lighting is so weird on me, man. I just got these lights not long ago. I've done like 2 or 3 streams with them, and they're like high quality, but man, are they bright.
Wait, really?
Yeah, a fictional one anyway. Okay, alright. Yuri's back on the book. Hey, look, I'm not that shallow, alright? I'm playing dating sim boy here.
Monica kind of whispers that last part to me. It's just a hunch, but...
Well, there's not really anything wrong with that.
Oh, well, I know. I was just saying. But anyway, you want to read my poem now? I like the way this one turned out, so I hope you do too.
Alright, let's take a look. Ooh, this one's shorter. Okay. Oh man, look at this. Alright, you want to get... Here, we'll get... Hang on.
The poem that we are speaking tonight is entitled Save Me. The name of the artist? Monica. Save me. The colors, they won't stop. Bright, beautiful colors, flashing, expanding, piercing. This is stupid. Red, green, blue, an endless cacophony. Is it really fucking, hang on, we're putting this down. I don't want to fucking, like, weird you out. An endless cacophony of meaningless noise. The noise, it won't stop. Violent, grating waveforms, squeaking, screeching, piercing, sine, cosine, tangent. Like playing a chalkboard on a turntable. Like playing a vinyl on a pizza crust. An endless poem of meaningless.
Fuck. Oh, oh, oh. Load me. Okay. Fair enough. Immersion broken. I'm sorry. I've ruined the stream. Another reason I have to delete the VOD now. Damn it. Hum. It's even more abstract than your last one, huh? I guess it's just the way I write. I'm sorry if you don't like it. No, I never said that. It's just kind of the thing that I've never really seen before, I guess. I kind of like playing with my space on the paper. Choosing where and how to space your words can totally change the mood of the poem. I mean, she's supposed to be the good one. Like, she's the fucking founder of the club, by the way. You know, it's funny, back in the University of Hartford, I founded a club as well. And it was equally as dorky. It was the History Association. A bunch of us got together because there was no history thing. And, like, we did but we knew how to get people. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, you know what we did? Our first event on campus... Like, it's a college campus, so you know people are, you know their heads, at least the ones who wouldn't be interested normally. We did a big presentation in an auditorium on the history of weed legalization in this country. And you know what? People showed up. And you know I made brownies. And they were supposed to be brownies, but they were brownies. They were just brownies. But, yeah, I know the feel. I certainly know the feel. It's almost like magic. The way I wrote the lines really short makes it feel like they're trying to speak over the noise. I guess. I mean, I see. It's still hard for me to tell what it's about, though. All it takes is weed. I know. And from then on, we gained maybe like, I think we had two or three like permanent guys after that. John. But most of them were a one-time gig. They saw us and they were like, yep, we're in. We even had this, one of our professors was this guy who's like, he was one of the guys who originally lobbied for legalization of it back in like the 60s, like the early 70s, I think. But, and he was the one we had present. Guy was smart. Guy was a genius. He just also happened to be a stoner. Sometimes asking what a poem is about isn't the right question. A poem can be as abstract as a physical expression of a feeling or a conversation with the reader. So putting it that way, not every poem is about something. Anyway, here's Monica's writing tip of the day. Alright, you taking notes? You taking notes? Here we go. Sometimes you'll find yourself facing a difficult decision. When that happens, don't forget to save your game. You never know when you might change your mind, or when something unexpected may happen. Wait, is this tip even about writing? What am I even talking about? That's my advice for today. Thanks for listening. Patepa, patepa. Oh, maybe I should fucking... Good point, actually. Let's save the game. I did that in the first one. I screwed up and I didn't... You could save life, sure. It's, I mean, I guess I can't think of anything. I was like, what's an example of saving life? I guess, fucking, I don't even know. Therapy? Alright, Sayori's left. I like Sayori too, but she's too boppy. She's too boppy, and I'm too boppy. If you get two boppy people in the same room like that, bad things happen. Dot, dot, dot. Oh, I gave her a really, ooh, I like this one, DG. Creating one. Easy. Oh, yeah. Really? It has some nice feelings in it. I'm glad. Does that mean it's better than yesterday's? Let me think. I don't know. I guess I like them both. Eh-heh-heh. That's not very helpful, you know. Well, I'm not very good at figuring out if poems are good or bad, but that's why I go by my heart. If it makes me feel things, then it must be a good poem. I'm not sure that's exactly how it works. But then again, I guess conveying feelings is a pretty important part of this whole thing. Yeah, maybe. Honestly, I don't even know what kind of writing you like in the first place. Yeah, me neither. Yeah, me neither. Ugh. Why don't you at least try giving it some thought? She's like the longtime childhood friend who brought me here and, like, strong-armed me into the club. You want to write something for me? That's so sweet.
Yeah, right.
But you're always thinking about other people. You need to think about yourself once in a while. If you don't, you might end up getting hurt at some point.
Eh?
Well, I don't really know what you mean, but I'll try to keep it in mind.
Look at that face. So that, is that sweat or is that a tear? That's sweat. She's sweaty. Well, whatever.
Anyway, let's see. I guess I like happy poems. Me too. Wait, sometimes I like sad poems too.
Me too.
Sometimes a little bit of both. There's a word for that, right? What's the word I'm looking for? Indecisive. Bittersweet! Yeah, I like things that are happy and things that are sad.
Happy and sad? That's fucking impossible!
I'm sorry.
I can't see you liking something sad, Sayori.
Well, I like happy the most. But sometimes when you have a little rain cloud in your head, a sad poem can help give the rain cloud a little hug and make a nice happy rainbow.
This is driving me insane, man. Like, something needs to happen. I'm sorry. It's still good. It's still good. I just need to stick it out.
It is. Maybe I'm getting better at expressing my feelings after all. Thanks, DG. I should go write that down then.
Yeah.
You can read my poem now, okay?
Bottles. All right, here we go.
I pop off my scalp like the lid of a cookie jar.
I can't do the voice, man. It's the secret place. I know something's coming, man. I know. People played it on like Halloween for a couple years. Like, there's something coming.
I pop off my scalp like the lid of a cookie jar. It's the secret place where I keep all of my dreams. Little balls of sunshine all rubbing together like a bundle of kittens. I reach inside with my thumb and forefinger and pluck one out.
Oh, I'm sorry, that capped the hell out of the mic.
It's warm and tingly. See? But there's no time to waste. I put it in a bottle to keep it safe. And I put the bottle on a shelf with all the other bottles.
I could go for a fucking bottle right now.
And I put the bottle with the other bottles. Happy thoughts, happy thoughts, happy thoughts in bottles all in a row.
An 8 to 10 sound.
I'm chock full of them. My collection makes me lots of friends. Each bottle of starlight to make amends. Sometimes my friend feels a certain way. That's me. Down comes a bottle to save the day. Night after night, more dreams.
Thought it said more Dems. Like, Democrats? Like, what?
Friend after friend, more bottles. Deeper and deeper my fingers go. Like exploring a dark cave. Discovering the secrets, hiding in the nooks and crannies, digging and digging, scraping and scraping. I blow dust off of my bottle caps. It doesn't feel like time elapsed. My empty shelf could use some more. My friends look through my locked front door. Finally, all done. I open up and in come my friends. In they come in such a hurry. Do they want my bottles that much? Is she...
It's kind of sensual.
Frantically pull them from the shelf one after another, holding them out to each and every friend, each and every bottle. But every time I let one go, it shatters against the tile between my feet. Happy thoughts, happy thoughts, happy thoughts in shards all over the floor.
Ooh, ooh. All right, all right, all right.
They were supposed to be for my friends who aren't smiling. They're all shouting, pleading something. But all I hear is echo, 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 echo inside my head.
Ooh, that's fucking... That's some good, tasty poetry right there, baby.
Just fucking almost drooled all over myself.
Holy crap!
That wasn't bad.
Hang on, my audio is definitely capping. I'm gonna vanish one more time here. Bring the mic audio down a tiny bit. There we go. Okay, alright. On we go. So she's kicking butt. She's kicking buttocks at her poem development. Her last one was iffy. Sayori, did you really write this?
Of course I did. Didn't I tell you yesterday I was gonna write the best poem ever?
I mean, it's not that, but it's good. Didn't expect something like this coming from you.
Monica taught me a whole lot, and I've been really in touch with my feelings recently.
I see that. It's almost kind of creepy. What a dick move. That's not nice.
That's not nice. Creepy? What the hell?
Well, not exactly. Maybe because I'm so used to being cheerful. Well, never mind. It was pretty damn cheerful still, except for the payoff at the end. I'm thinking too hard about it. The point is, it came out good, so you should be proud of it.
Aw, oh, thanks. I feel like I was meant to express myself this way. Express yourself! It even helps me understand my own feelings a little bit better. Writing is like magic!
You've gotten pretty passionate about this, huh? I hope you keep it up.
Yeah! Writing's the best! I'm gonna keep writing until I die.
Me too. I did try back in high school. Like, during my free periods for like 2 years straight, like two semesters, I was writing like a fantasy. I wanted to write a fantasy series, not just a fantasy book, a series. And I got like 70 pages in, front and back, on like lined paper with pencil. And like, eventually I was like, all right, this ain't happening. But I read it again like some years later and I was like, this is terrible. But it was the thought that counted, and at least I wasn't out doing drugs or something. I was writing fantasy novels like a cool kid. Don't get ahead of yourself. Sayori's always had a habit of getting obsessed with something before dropping it no more than a week later. I wonder if this is one of those times. But seeing the passion in her eyes makes it hard for me to be pessimistic.
Hi, Monica.
Drugs are bad. Take that to heart. Animu said it in chat, but all y'all watching the VOD and stuff too, as long as the VOD's not deleted because I make a doof of myself, I would never delete it for that reason, by the way. Drugs are bad. Drink alcohol in moderation, and only if you're of legal age to do so. And I may have to do some of that shortly.
Okay, everyone. We're all done reading each other's poems, right? I have something extra planned today. So if everyone could come sit at the front of the room...
What was my... is this about the festival?
Well, sort of. Do we really have to do something for the festival? It's not like we can put together anything good in just a few days.
Guys,
we'd just end up embarrassing ourselves instead of getting any new members. That's a concern of mine as well. I don't really do well with last-minute preparations, like Preparation H or I. Don't worry so much. We're going to keep it simple, okay? We won't need much more than a few decorations. Sayori's been working on posters, and I've designed some pamphlets we can give out during the event.
Okay, well, that's great and all, but doesn't tell us what we're actually going to be doing for the event.
Ah, sorry, I thought you heard about it already. We're going to be performing! Woo!
Capping the audio. Performing. P.
Monica? Yeah, we're going to be having a poetry performance. Each of us are going to choose a poem to recite during the event. But the cool part is, we're also going to let anyone else come up and recite poems too.
Sayori's been putting it in all the posters in case anyone wants to prepare ahead of time. Sayori, who has been coloring a poster, holds it up for us to see.
Are you kidding me, Monica? You didn't already start putting these posters up, did you? Well, I did. Do you really think it's that bad of an idea?
Well, no, it's not a bad idea, but I didn't sign up for this, you know? Like, or something.
There's no way I'm going to be performing in front of a bunch of people like that. I agree with Natsuki. I could never, in my life, do something like that.
Imagining it, Yuri shakes her head in fear.
Guys!
No,
Sayori, I understand where they're coming from. Remember that Natsuki and Yuri have never shared their poems with anyone until just a couple days ago. It's a lot to ask for them to recite their poems out loud to a whole room full of people. I guess I kind of overlooked that. So I'm sorry. Dot, dot, dot. But I still think we should give it our best. We were the only ones responsible for the fate of this club. If we start the event and each put on a good performance, then it will inspire...
It will inspire others to do the same. And the more people perform, the better we'll be able to show up in the literature all about.
Yeah, it's about expressing your feelings, being intimate with yourself, finding new horizons, and having fun.
That's right.
And it's those reasons that we'll all be in, that we are all in this club today. Don't you want to share that with others? To inspire them to find the same feelings brought you here in the first place? I know you do. I know we all do. And if all it takes is standing in front of the room for 2 minutes and reciting a poem, then I know you can do it. Dot, 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 dot. Natsuki and Yuri remain silent. Fucking buzzkills. Sari looks worried. I guess that leaves me no choice. I agree. This is what happened to me with the that made me go into the club in the first place. Is like they were all salty and I felt guilty, so I hopped in. Alright, on we go. Doki, doki, doki. This music though, like fucking, it gets up in here. It does dig its way into your brain. Be, be, be. Literature. I think that Sayori and Monica have been trying really hard to get new members. Least we can do is help them out at least just a little bit. Well, maybe, but looks like Natsuki doesn't have any arguments left. You gotta do it. Ugh. Okay, fine. I guess I'll just have to get it over with. Alright. Phew. Thanks, Natsuki. What about you, Yuri? Yuri dejectedly glances around at everyone else's expectant faces. Sigh. I guess I don't really have a choice. Aha, that's everyone! You're the best, Yuri! This club is seriously going to be the death of me. Oh gosh. You'll be fine, Yuri. But anyway, let's move on to the main event.
At WrestleMania!
I almost actually just fucking nailed the mic, too. That would have been unfortunate.
I want you to choose a poem of yours. We're going to practice reciting them in front of each other. And no way.
No way! Monica, this is too sudden.
Well, if you can't recite your poem in front of the club, how do you expect to do it in front of strangers?
Oh, no.
Don't worry. I'll start off to help everyone feel more comfortable.
Can I go next?
Ah-ha-ha, of course. Now let's see. Monica Flip... For some reason, I read her name as Monkey on that one. I was like, Monkey? Monkey Flips? Threw her notebook to the specific poem she has in mind for herself. She then stands behind the podium. The title of this poem is The Way They Fly. Monica begins reciting her poem. Her clear, confident voice fills the room. More than that, her inflection is pristine. She knows exactly how to apply emotion behind every line she recites, bringing the words to life. Is this something she's done before, or is she simply a natural? I glance around me. Everyone has their eyes on Monica. Sayori looks amazed. Yuri has an intense expression on her face that I can't understand. Finally, Monica finishes the recitation.
That's the word of the day right there, recitation.
The four of us applaud. Monica, actually no, when they do poems, don't they, when if you go to like a poetry like bar, don't they snap instead of applauding? Yes, yes, very good, very good. Monica takes a breath and smiles.
That was so good, Monica.
Thank you very much. I was just hoping to set a good example. You ready to go next to your Sayori?
I'll go next.
Oh shit, the boldness. She's getting bold. That word's too big for your smile. You're preaching to the choir, my friend. Today's recitation is pasta fagioli.
Wah! Yuri's fired up all of a sudden.
Yuri clutches a sheet of paper between her hands and stands up. I sympathize with Yuri and her weird fucking like bony like wrist.
I got a couple of those. She's doing like a. She's fucking really. She's really got that sucker cranked, huh?
Keeping her head down, she walks quickly over to the podium. This poem is called. Yuri anxiously glances at each of us. You can do it, Yuri. It's called The Afterimage of a Crimson Eye.
Yuri's voice shakes as she starts reading the poem. Just a moment ago, she practically refused to do this. Why is she suddenly putting in so much effort?
As Yuri gets past the first couple of lines, her voice changes. It's almost like what happens when Yuri gets absorbed in her books. Her quivering voice words, that thing, transforms into the sharp syllables of a fierce and confident woman. Okay, I'm back on Team Yuri again. I'm back in Yuri's corner.
The poem is full of twists and turns in its structure that she enunciates with perfect timing. This must be a rare glimpse into the whirling fire Yuri keeps concealed inside her head. Suddenly, she's finished. Everyone is stunned. The beast was stunned.
Yuri snaps back into reality and glances around her as if she is bewildered, even herself.
It's up to me to save this situation. I'm the first to start applauding. Oh, then you gotta do like a...
So concerned. Everyone joins me afterwards. We give Yuri the recognition she deserves.
That definitely capped the audio. I apologize.
It's not that we didn't want to applaud for her, but we were caught so off guard we must have forgotten. If you've heard of the YouTube channel The Game Theorists, you should watch his theory videos on this game. It's very interesting. When I finish the game, I'll check them out, man.
I don't know when that's going to be. I have no idea how long this game is, but I mean, I'm two parts in at this point. We'll see.
The Game Theorists. I know of them.
We were caught so off guard, we must have forgotten. As we applaud, Yuri holds the poem to her chest and rushes back to her seat.
I was about to hold my jury summons up to my chest to emulate that, but I realize it's probably got like my personal shit all over it. So I'm not gonna do that. Sorry, Russian hackers watching this under like a bot name.
Yuri, that was really good. Thank you for sharing.
Looks like Yuri's down for the count.
Okay, I guess I'm next then. Sayori hops out of her chair and cheerfully walks the podium. This one's called My Meadow. Sorry, I giggled.
Sayori.
It's a lot harder than I thought. How did you guys do it so easily? Try not to think of it like you're reciting to other people. Imagine you're reciting it to yourself. In your underwear. In front of a mirror. Or in your own head. In front of Eminem. It's your poem, so it'll come out the best that way.
I see. Okay then.
Sayori begins her poem. Somehow it feels like her soft voice was made as a perfect match. The poem isn't aimlessly cheery, like Sayori is. It's serene and bittersweet. If I were to read this on paper, I probably wouldn't think much of it, but hearing it come from Sayori's voice almost gives it a whole new meaning. Maybe this is what Sayori meant when she said she likes my poems. It's like I get to reach more deeply into someone. Whew, interesting word choice. I thought I knew through and through.
Sayori finishes, and we applaud.
Brava. A brava.
I did it!
Good job, Sayori.
Even DG liked it, that's me. I guess that is a good sign.
What does that even mean?
It came out nicely, Sayori. The atmosphere of the poem fits you really nicely. But it might be that other poems wouldn't work quite as well with that kind of delivery. I don't really understand.
In other words, I've seen poems of yours where that sort of gentle delivery wouldn't work so well. They might need a little more force behind them, depending on what you're reading.
Oh, I know what you mean.
It's just embarrassing to do in front of everyone.
So what's this? They got some interesting shit going on in this game, I'll tell you that much. What's this?
I do have that same fucking like goblin smile that she has on her face though.
You'll be back a little later. Go ahead, take your time. I'll continue making an arse of myself for a little while.
And I'll be here. Poem.
We don't really have much time left before the festival, you know?
Okay. Now who's next?
Natsuki.
Don't make me go for DG. It's not like I can compare to you guys anyway. Might as well let DG lower everyone's standards a little before I have to do it.
Natsuki. It's fine, it's fine. Might as well get it over with.
But it's not like I have much of a selection of what to read. I'll just have to go with what I wrote for today. I stand up and step in front of the podium. Everyone has their eyes on me, making me feel terribly awkward. I recite my poem. This poem is called BYOB, originally written by System of a Down. Since I'm not exactly confident in my own writing, it's hard to put energy into it. Despite that, once I finish, I receive applause anyway. Sorry, I'm not really as good as everyone else.
Don't worry about it so much. I think it's less about your abilities and more about your lack of confidence in your writing.
Hey, fuck off! I was confident.
I confidently chose to kiss Yuri's ass.
Give me this. Give me this. I want this.
I want this.
This is not gonna work.
That's something that I'll prove over time, though.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe.
Alright then. That just leaves you, Natsuki.
Yeah, yeah. I'm going.
Natsuki begrudgingly gets out of her seat and makes her way to the podium. This poem is called... It's called... Why are you all looking at me?
Because you're presenting.
Anyway, the poem is called Jump.
This one's by Van Halen.
I get up, and nothing gets me down.
Natsuki takes a breath. When she starts reciting her poem, her sour attitude disappears a little. This ain't happening.
Gotta listen to this fucking weird, like, loop again.
While she's still a little unenthused, her poem has a rhythm and a rhyme to it.
DG is a bit sus. Oh yeah, Dragon? I ain't the one looking sus here. I'm also the one with the ban button, so you better watch. I'm just kidding. I wouldn't dare. How you doing? Yeah, weird choice of game, huh? Welcome aboard. The reason I'm playing this, I'll take a second. Like, just cause, like, say, so I never played this before. And a few days ago, I was Christmas shopping, and I saw it on the PS5 rack at GameStop. And I was like, no way! Because, like, I knew this game was, like, a big thing, like, a few years back. It was, like, one of those fad games, and, like, I know there's something Halloween-y about it, because people were freaked out about it. Just awake at AM on a Thursday? I mean, everyone tends to be awake during AM. It's during PM that they go to sleep. I'm sorry, being a smartass. But yeah, I don't know if you're familiar with this game. It's like a dating sim, but apparently, like, at the beginning there was a warning saying, like, don't, you know, if you have any sort of anxiety or depression things, like, this game might be a little rough. Keep that in mind, too. It didn't read the 1 a.m., dude, man. That's not so bad. Oh, God. But have you played this before? So, like... I started yesterday, and the VOD got deleted, unfortunately. There was an issue with connection. The VOD it got screwed up. But, before this, I'd never played before yesterday. I had seen, like, a meme. Like, I've seen the Just Monica meme. And I know it's something to do with Monica, the character, I would have to assume. You've heard of it? Yeah, supposedly it is a, like, really crazy, like, cerebral game. But so far, it's just been a fucking dating sim, man. I don't know what to say. I was talking to a couple people in chat before you showed up who said that it is a, you know, a weirder game. Color me intrigued. They said that it does have, it's a slow burner. Like, it's supposed to pop up and, like, that's no good. It's supposed to get crazier. So I'm holding out hope. The Karen Simulator? Is that a thing? Oh my god. I will make a note of that for you, Dragon. Who knows? Maybe we'll pop that one in with Thursday or Saturday stream, for that matter. I know this is an off day. I'm doing a random off day here. Basically what's happened so far is I got roped into a literature club by my best friend, my, like, longtime best friend. And it's full of these cute girls. There's 4 of them. And I've been trying to impress Yuri. She's got big, tall girl with purple hair. And
been going her route, and they're doing like a festival, a literature festival, where I basically have to deliver a poem in front of a big crowd. Something like that. You play as a Karen, I figured. Yeah, well, definitely, I'm gonna make a note of that. If it's like $40, we're not playing it. But if it's like a Steam game, I'm on board. All right, let me hop back in here. It's Natsuki's trademark style, and it works surprisingly well when spoken aloud. The words feel like they bounce up and down, as if giving life to the poem. I figured it would be. I figured it'd be pretty cheap, but, you know, you never know. This one was free, but yeah, they're selling it for PS5. I assume, like, there's like a plus edition. I saw it on Steam too for like $30, so I'm trying to get to something to happen. Not that I'm not invested, I'm invested. It's about $2. Yeah, we could do that. We can make that happen. Yeah, I'm invested, don't get me wrong. I want to impress Yuri. I'm not fucking leaving until I do. Natsu finishes, everyone applauds. Brava, brava. She huffs back to her seat.
That wasn't so bad, was it?
Is it for you to say? That's the voice of Ginner. Is it for you to say? Cha. You better not make me do that again. We just said you're gonna do it again at the fucking festival. That's the point of this.
Do you at least prepare enough to recite a poem in front of other people?
I mean, doing it in front of other people would be way easier. I could put on whatever face I want for other people. That's kind of how I am too, man. I get really nervous like performing songs or streaming in front of like family. I mean, I haven't really streamed in front of family yet, but I would be nervous. But when it comes to like crowds, I love crowds, man. I'm a ham. Put me front and center. Put me in the old eye of the old fucking whatchamacallit here. Usually. Unless it's a police camera. It's just embarrassing.
That's a surprise, Natsuki.
That's my best friend from like longtime best friend who wrote me in.
I think it'd be the other way around for me.
Well, that's just how it is, so.
Well, I guess in that case, you won't have much to worry about for the festival. That said, I want to thank everyone for coming through. It might be hard, but I hope you all have an idea of what it's like now. Just make sure you pick a poem and get enough practice before the festival, okay? I'll be making pamphlets, so let me know ahead of time.
Jeez. I should probably find some other poem to recite instead.
That's fine, too. It doesn't have to be your own. I'm already pleasantly surprised that you're putting in this effort for the club.
Yeah, me too. Me too, Monica.
It makes me really happy.
Yeah, no problem.
Okay, everyone. I think that's about it for today. I know the festival's coming up, but let's try to write poems for tomorrow as well. It's been working out really nicely so far, so I'd like to continue that. As for the festival, we'll finish planning tomorrow, and then we'll have the weekend to prepare. Monday's the big day. I can't wait.
I can do this. I can do this. All right. I stand up. There's no way I'll be able to find the same enthusiasm as Sayori and Monica, but I'll do my best to get through it. If it's for the sake of the club. And impressing Monica. No, Sayori. Impressing Sayori. Or Monica. I kind of like Monica, too. I'm thinking about it. Ready to go, Sayori.
Yep.
Look at you two. Always gone home together like that.
It's kind of adorable, isn't it?
Hehehe. Jeez, guys. Don't make such a big deal out of it.
It must be a little nice, though.
There's Yuri. That's her. That's her right there. Just fucking, yep. It's her. It's gonna be her. Well. How am I supposed to respond to that? God, it's so cutesy, dude. It's so cutesy.
It's okay, DG. You don't have to say it.
Whatever. Let's go already. This is my nice-ass, like, house. My nice condo. Look at this shit, man. Like, I definitely want to go to Japan someday. I want to go to Tokyo and check it out. And if I can get away with finding a spot that's more like traditional, like I'd like to go out somewhere into the countryside, that they have English because I can't speak Japanese. That'd be nice. Just looks so freaking beautiful. I walk up with Sayori once more. Even though it's only been a few days, a lot of things have already changed. Yeah, man, Tokyo would be so cool. Even the big city, even though I know big cities tend to sort of mesh together, but Tokyo is special, from what I've seen at least. I like these fucking, like, these carport awnings. These are sweet. Oh, man. Even though it's only been a few days, a lot of things have already changed. But today, is Sayori's being a little quieter than usual on the way home. Hey, Sayori. She's feeling bad because she sent me to a club with a bunch of sexy, fucking confident girls. And she's beginning to realize the error of her ways. And she actually, her last poem that you just missed was like way more profound. You can tell she's like, she's macking on old Tinderbox even more. And I haven't been reciprocating because I'm a meanie. It wouldn't be so fun when you're gonna eat because you're a picky eater. Oh, if you're a picky eater, you're in trouble. Man, that like, so after I went to Spain, I remember we were talking about that. I lived in Morocco for like about a month. Because we didn't have visas, I wasn't allowed to fly out of Spain. Like, we never, like, it was the first year that we were doing that program, so nobody really had a groundwork. And I was like, what do? I can't get home. And me and the other kid, Ricky, had an Arabic teacher. She was like, come stay with us. We'll stay with my family from there. You can stay for, like, a month, and then you'll fly back out of there. And, like, they were, like, a French territory for a while, so they have a lot of French stuff, but they also have like, so they have like escargot and all that, but they also have like the Moroccan spices. You're making a geo map. You got 27 locations? Holy crap. All right, you know, Thursday I'm probably gonna start. Tomorrow's Thursday, isn't it? Tomorrow I'm probably gonna start with geo. So if you're around Thursday around this time, actually about an hour earlier is when I'll start, I'd be down to check it out. Hell yeah. Oh, I tried it. Well, yeah, but if you're at 27 locations, today's Thursday. All right, for you. So in that case, if you're going to be around later today, around the same time, oh man, I forgot how fucking your time is so scratchy. Same time tonight. I'll be down, or Saturday. Saturday night for you. Won't make it. School, I feel your pain, man. I went through that for quite some time. But that's okay. Saturday, I'll be going to. Especially because GeoGuessr's been pulling a lot of, like, most of my viewer base for some reason. So I'll be back on that, at least for a bit this weekend. But yeah, Moroccan food, spices. Some of those were hot as hell. Like, I was not prepared. Last year of middle school, congrats! You are going to love... If high school over there is the same, like, the same time span as it is here, 4 years, like immediately after middle school, like, high school's so fun. I'm gonna tell you right now, like, freshman year and junior year were my favorites, for sure. You're gonna get so much more freedom than the smaller one, the lower ones afford. Okay, back to our girl Sayori here. She's feeling conflicted, and we must soothe her.
Sorry, I was spacing out.
Ooh, ooh, I can make that face really good. Ooh, probably because I don't have any hair. No wonder.
I was thinking about something from earlier. I like how we get to, I mean,
Sayori fumbles with her words.
So let's just say that one day, Yuri asked to walk home with you.
Oh no, yep, I'm gonna have to do this. I'm gonna have to do the fucking... This is a situation I've never been in real life, and I'm glad. But I'm gonna have to let her down. Huh? I mean, I've ended relationships before, but I've never had something like this, where somebody, like, close to me was crushing on me, and I had to let him down. High school's free there? Very nice. I don't even remember. I don't think ours was.
What kind of question is that? You're kind of putting me on the spot here.
I mean, if Yuri offered to walk home with me, yeah, I would walk home with Yuri. But guess what? You know what Yuri isn't right now? She's not in front of me. So I can say I would still walk home with Sayori. I'm sorry, okay? That's how it goes. That's how it would go.
Sayori, you really think I'd ditch you for Yuri? Eh? But she's so beautiful and smart.
Yes, those are true. I already see her in the club every day. Besides, you always seem to really like going home together. I just wouldn't just ruin that for you.
You're so silly, DG. You think about me too much sometimes. Yuri would deserve it even if she wanted it, so...
Sayori, I've already made up my mind. Are they gonna end up like... Like, attacking each other for me? Like, is that how this is gonna go? Is this like a commentary on, like, dating sims? Like, are they gonna get ravenous and start beating the hell out of each other?
Sayori, I've already made my mind. I really can't figure you out sometimes.
Sorry.
Besides, what's the point in speculating something that's never going to happen? The conversation trails off. It's kind of a weird thing for Sayori to care so much about. But I want to respect her and keep her happy too. Then again, the festival's only a few days away. Or was it a day away? Hang on.
Fuck!
A few days. Okay, we have a few days here. Good, good, good. Hop on the good foot. Oh, here we go. So this is what you have to do. Basically, like, I have to write a poem, and each word corresponds to one of the girls. So I click one, and you'll see they'll hop up and down. I still want Yuri, man. Yuri's my girl. So she's the deep girl, right? She's like,
universe. Yeah, after image. Disaster. Unstable.
Incongruent. I remember that one from yesterday.
Contamination.
Excitement? No! Bollocks. Fucking covet. But yeah, high school over here was great, at least. I assume it's the same. It just in general, like, once you hit that age, you'll see, like, people start trusting you with more. You may get to pick more of your courses. It's so much more fun. Don't go too crazy. Don't go too crazy. But have fun. Have fun and do some crazy things. Just don't tell them that DG Tinderbox told you to do so.
Heaven sent. Uncontrollable.
Suicide. Holy shit.
All right.
Disoriented. Hey, she hopped a little on that one.
Spinning.
No, not happy spinning. Emotional spinning.
You're doing the cooking?
Dude, that's awesome. I wish I learned how to cook earlier. Definitely, that's important. That's important. Learn how to make all sorts of good stuff. Do you like cooking?
Like, you want to learn recipes early on. It changes everything. If you end up, like, throughout your, like, early adulthood, you'll end up eating just fast food and junk and crap. And then end up having a kidney stone like Tinderbox did at 28. Don't let that happen. Learn how to cook. Learn how to cook and then learn how to cook.
Humans.
No, don't do that.
Headphones. No, not headphones.
Entropy.
Disarray.
Graveyard.
Forgive?
Oh, no. Extra, no.
Harpy.
No, I'm blowing it, man. I'm blowing it here.
You do cook? That's awesome.
That's awesome.
Anger. I should have known that was her. Effulgent. There we go. Yeah. Now we're talking.
First year is cooking in general. Second year is the courses for people that make desserts. 2 years working. That's so cool. That's really cool. That's even better because over here, like, the high schools don't really offer special... They try to offer specialized courses, but it's pretty much just a general education. Like, you go... And they teach you about, like, the mitochondria. And they teach you about calculus. And they teach you about the War of 1812. They don't teach you how to do your taxes. They don't teach you how to do anything, like, that you would use for a career. So you are in the right mindset, my friend. That's the way to do it.
Oh, God. Plus, that means you'll get really good at it.
Hell, you probably already are.
Aw, man. I'm the last one here again. Don't worry, I just walked in too.
Were you practicing piano again?
Yeah.
You must have a lot of determination. Starting this club and now picking up piano?
Well, maybe not determination, but I guess passion. Remember that the club wouldn't be here if it wasn't for all of you. And I'm super happy that you're all willing to go out for the festival to help for the festival too.
I don't know where I read go out for.
I can't... Oh, well, what? She's smiling. She can smile? She has the capability?
You can choose between advanced and easy math?
Yeah.
Easy.
Easy math, for sure.
See, back when I was doing... Back in fucking my math class, they said you wouldn't have a calculator in your pocket. I know it's a fucking meme already, and it's a boomer trope, but it's true.
And now we do. She's fucking happy. Ah, I can't wait for the festival. It's gonna be great. Cha. Weren't you complaining about it just yesterday? Well, see, I kind of like her now. Now that she's fucking cheery.
Well, yeah. I'm not talking about our part of the festival, but it's a whole day of school where you get to play and eat all kinds of delicious food.
You sound a bit like Sayori all of a sudden.
Monica.
Do they usually have fried squid?
Squid.
That's a pretty specific thing to look forward to. Oh, come on. Are you saying you don't like squid? You of all people?
I didn't say I don't like it. Besides, what do you mean by you of all people?
Because it's right in your name.
Monica.
Eh. That's not how you say my name at all.
Also, that joke makes no sense in translation. Okay, all right. I get it.
Is Mon or Ika squid?
Oh, God.
Cheesy. I didn't think this was a translated game. I still don't think it was a translated game.
Never mind. Let's just focus on our own event for now, okay?
Fine. Your reactions aren't as fun as Yuri's or Sayori's anyway.
Excuse me. Where is Sayori anyway?
Oh, there you are.
Sayori's sitting at a desk in the corner of the room looking down at nothing. Oh, she's definitely feeling the fucking... She's feeling the,
Look, alright, I wanted... I'm going after Yuri, alright?
And it would appear that I'm going to have to, I'm going to have to talk Sayori out of a funk. She's in a funk.
Hey, Sayori!
I wave my hand in front of her face.
She's dead!
She's a...
Eh?
You're spacing out on me again.
Ah. Sorry.
She's doing like a... Wait, I got this, alright? There you go, I did the Sayori.
This music gets in your brain, man, it really does.
Do 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 do. Ba da da ba da ba da ba. Talk to everyone.
Okay, I will try.
Why wouldn't it be? It just feels like you're a little off.
Sorry for assuming things.
Jeez, you worry too much about me. I'm fine, see?
Sayori shows me a big smile.
Don't let me distract you from having fun with everyone.
Well, all right.
See, this is the point where you sit down and you, like, you don't just... I mean, alright, this is like high school or like an early college kid, so I get it.
You gotta go before she wakes up and catches you being up. Go ahead, man, take a rest. Get some rest. Thanks for stopping by. If you can, I hope to see you Saturday, but either way, you have a good night.
I'll continue making a butt of myself over here.
I worriedly glance at Sarah before turning back towards everyone else.
No turn back. Go see her.
The conversations are dispersed. Maybe I should ask Monica if she's noticed anything about Sarah recently, since they've been preparing for the festival. They must be spending a lot of time together.
I timidly approach Monica. I'm gonna do the Sayori one. I timidly approach Monica, who's shuffling through some papers at her desk.
She's taking a flight at 5 a.m. I hate that. That is not fun.
But, It does beat sometimes, at least for me. It's better than leaving at like 2 p.m. and getting there at like midnight.
So,
good luck to her as well then.
I'm going to Monica.
DG, what's up?
Hey, this might sound a little strange, but have you noticed anything up with Sayori recently? Anything up with her?
In what way do you mean?
Maybe I'm reading into it a little too much, but she seems a bit downcast today.
Oh, you think so?
I can't say I've noticed anything about her. Monica peers across the room at Sayori, who is idly dragging a rubber eraser up and down her desk. Yeah, she's a little fucking salty about something.
Maybe there's something on her mind, but I'm surprised I'm not the one asking you, DG. You certainly know her a lot better than I do.
Yeah, but she's never really like this. She's always talked to me about things that bothered her. But this time, when I asked her, she was really dismissive. Sorry, I know it's not your problem. I just wanted to ask if you knew anything, so I'll drop it now.
Drop it!
No.
It's important to me too. I mean, I'm also friends with her, and I also care about the well-being of my club members, you know? Maybe I'll try talking to her myself.
You sure about that? Ow. Hang on, I gotta bump the audio up one more time. Bear with me. This will be quick. This will be painless. Oh yeah, you like my little note here? That's about like my fucking like the levels that I'm actually looking at right now. I forgot that you can see those now. And nobody can say DG Tinderbox ain't prepared.
Are you sure about that?
Ah, son of a bitch. I keep forgetting that that's like tied to the other screen now. There we go.
Seemed like she wanted to be left alone. You sure? Maybe she just has a hard time bringing it up with the person of interest.
Yep, alright, here we go. Our fucking concrete-headed narrator here is about to get a dose of truth. The little nose. Look at her little fucking... Look at her little nose and her little mouth. Person of interest? What do you mean by that?
I'm saying that maybe the thing on her mind is you, DG.
Me? How on earth do you come to that conclusion?
Well, I probably shouldn't say too much, but Sayori talks about you more than anything else, you know?
Eh?
She's been so much happier ever since you joined the club. It's like an extra light was turned on inside of her.
What? No way. Sayori is always like that. She's always been full of sunshine. It's not any different now than it always has been.
You're so funny, DG.
Fucking idiot.
Have you thought that maybe you've always seen her as so cheerful because that's just how she is when she's around you?
Dot, dot, dot.
I said too much. I'm sorry, what do I know anyway? I didn't mean to jump to conclusions, so you could just forget about what I said. I'll try to talk to her, so try not to think about it for now.
Ah, all right. Monica smiles meaningfully. I know she said to forget about it, but I already know that I won't be able to get her words out of my head.
Monica stands up from her desk and walks across the room to where Sayori is sitting. I watch her kneel down next to Sayori and gently talk to her. But she's keeping her voice so quiet, I can't hear it from here.
Have I hit anything exciting, Animu? Sayori is getting sad because I'm trying to hit on Yuri. And she's clearly starting to realize that bringing me to the club is awakening something in her. So she's very sad. Nothing scary has happened, if that's what you're asking. But now Monica's talking to her, so we're seeing. We will see.
I sigh and sit myself down. I know Sayori told me not to worry about her and to have fun with everyone else, but that's impossible to do while she's behaving like this. Exactly how much I do care about her that I'm letting this... Oh, how much do I care about her that I'm letting this weigh me down so much? Now, it feels like I'm the one behaving out of the ordinary, but there's nothing I can do besides wait for Monica. Why does it feel like I'm being watched? I glance around the room.
Hey, it's my girl. It's my girl. Alright, hang on. Before I speak to my girl, before I speak to my purple-haired Aphrodite, I'm gonna go get a drink. Because this is wearing on the old throat here. No. Still going after Yuri with Sayori getting the feels for me. Exactly. I'm gonna probably have to let her down gently. But, yeah. Anywho, I will be right back. I'm just gonna take a quick break, get a drink, hit the bathroom, make sure everything's good, everything's Gucci, and I will be right back, okay? Let's do this. Bum, 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 bum.
Solid intermission screen, thank you very much. Oh, let me show you something actually. I just added something new for that matter. Yeah, I've been designing a bunch of stuff, bunch of different screens and everything. And let me show you my newest thing. Hang on, how do I do this? Let me show you something cool. I gotta test it. I already saw it once. It happened once earlier in the stream, so I know it works. Bit bit bit. Where is it? I can't find it here. Wait, here it is. Okay, ready for this? Check this out. So I gotta go here. All right, ready for this? What program did I make that in? There is a website called Canva. It's a graphic design site where you can basically, like any sort of platform you can think of, any sort of multimedia. You can set up animated things, solid things. There's like a Photoshop style tool you can use. It's beautiful. It's really cool. And it's not that expensive either. But I've also created this. Ready? Check this out. So let's say I'm watching me and I'm like, oh, this me over here, he's fucking interesting, huh? He's pretty neat. I think I might want to follow him. So then I go, hey, where'd it go? Oh, I gotta be on the main screen. look. Hey. Let me do it again. I'll do it again for you. I've joined my own crew. Pretty neat. If I do say so myself. Now, where'd the game go? There she is. Yeah, I hope to see plenty more of that. My little follow animation. Alright, so I got Yuri. She was fucking spying on me, man. She knows. I wasn't exactly being subtle with it. So Yuri looks away just as quickly, with a flustered look on her face. I realize that I haven't fixed my level since I got back. Hang on, let me turn the music down a little for you. Damn it! The reason that it keeps vanishing whenever I touch something on that side is because I have a special thing running with this game in order to get it to go on this screen that screws up if you try to click any other screen, which is a pain in the bunder. It's a pain in the bunder, but I can live with it. Alright, Yuri. She won't get anywhere like this. I've never really seen Yuri approach anyone or start a conversation of her own accord. So I have no choice but to approach her myself. By now, it's a little easier for me to do that. Stand up from a desk and sit in the one next to her own. Yuri. Oh, here's her theme. This is Yuri's theme. Yeah, Canva. If you're interested in that, Canva, C-A-N-V-A, it's where I made that. It's where I made my, if you see on the screen, this little banner down here, this little blue thing. My starting soon screen, I made everything else. I made everything else by fucking hand when I first started, and that's why it sucks. but the Canva stuff looks great. I love it. .. I didn't mean to bother you or anything. Relax, you didn't even do anything. But I could tell you wanted to be alone with your thoughts. Alone with my thoughts? My thoughts? How were you even able to tell that I was thinking like that? That was weirdly worded. Well, it's something that I do a lot, so it wasn't hard for me to spot based on your posture and expression. Not that I was staring or anything. Staring at your rock-hard abs and your chiseled biceps. I know. And my wrist that looks like you could snap it like a carrot. I didn't do anything creepy like that. In any case, I guess you were right. I'm sorry if I caused you any concern.
Don't apologize. Your troubles are only the concern of those who willingly share in that concern. Of course, there are certainly those who find the most comfort in keeping to themselves.
You want to make short animations with your galaxy art? The website ain't gonna... No. If you're looking to make actual animations, you're probably gonna need something... You're gonna need something heftier than that. You're gonna need some kind of animation software. You might need, like, maybe Adobe Premiere. You might be able to find, like, a cheap or even a free animation software, but it can get pricey when it comes to animating. I know that much. Not that I've tried it, but just from all the streamer, like, there's an animation stream. If you like that sort of thing, if you like drawing or anything, there's this channel called Drawfee, Drawfee, where it's these professional artists, and they basically take suggestions of, like, weird prompts from their fan base, and then they do them. Like, they'll draw, like, I don't know, like, they'll draw famous people as Pokemon or something like that. I don't know. And they've been doing it for years. They're funny as hell. Strongly recommended, but yeah, they've said that, like, they have this special, like, super advanced program that's worth a ton of money. Anywho, if you'd prefer to listen to share, or prefer to share what's on your mind, I would be glad to listen. It's really not that big of a deal. I was just feeling a bit uneasy about Sayori.
Sayori?
Yeah, seems a little off today, but when I asked her about it, she didn't want to admit it to me. So I can't help but wonder if something happened to her.
Oh, that's quite romantic.
Eh.
Sorry, I didn't mean to say something stupid.
Give the Adobe stuff, but learning how to use it is annoying. Photoshop. Hey, Photoshop and Adobe isn't bad at all. Nothing to shake a stick at. But, yeah, I'm sorry, I'm not really the one to come to for animation advice, that's for darn sure. Best I ever did was like a flip book of a ball bouncing up and down. Check out Drawfee though. I know they mention sometimes what program they have. I think it's in like the descriptions and stuff too, and it's a damn good program. Maybe it's not that pricey either. I just didn't want you to misunderstand. Sayori and I have been friends for a long time, that's all. That's all, Yuri. So if you wanna, like, you know, we can go to the coffee house, we could grab a latte. We could talk about how your eyes disappeared.
Ah, I see. Then perhaps it is unusual for her to be dismissive to you about her feelings.
Or maybe I'm just reading into it a little too much.
DG, the world is full of meaning, often hidden deep beneath plain sight. And there are many untold mysteries behind every person, no matter how well you may know them.
Ah, so you think there might be something behind this after all?
I think that Sayori is a very complex person. Her mannerisms on the outside don't always match what may be going on inside her noodle. Inner noodle. And she may not always know what she wants. I noticed her strange behavior today too, and I also feel some concern for her. But in your case, it looked like she was fully occupying your thoughts, wasn't she?
No. Well, I mean, she's my fucking friend. Of course I'm gonna be like, yeah. I guess that was the case. Fine.
Sayori, she really means a lot to you, doesn't she?
I guess, but you don't need to put it that way. We're just good friends, that's all.
... Yuri suddenly looks deeply into my eyes. Her expression is gentle and curious.
And I avert my gaze because I skip the rest of the text.
Sometimes, a person's mysteries are untold even to themselves. And you, as someone honest and caring, you may uncover feelings you weren't aware were in you. That is, I think that she would be a very fortunate person to have you feel that way about her.
Oh, look at her blush. Look at her little blush. Look at her little blush and her pointy, like, Whoville nose.
Yuri, you're giving me too much credit.
I'm a pretty simple guy. So I think I'm pretty good at understanding my own feelings. I'm not nearly as sophisticated as you.
Me dumb protagonist.
That's not a compliment, is it?
It is what it is. Anyway, as long as we're here, why don't we do some reading?
Well, as long as you're okay with it.
Yeah, I should be taking my mind off this whole thing anyway.
Guys, this is slow. I mean, I feel like there's some sort of a relationship turning point coming up here. A bit of a fuckening. But... Monica! Still haven't given up on her either. Even though that bow is extra as hell. Like, what is that? Is that like a bow or is it... Yeah, it's a bow. It's a giant fucking bow for a ponytail. That's excessive. That's excessive, tiny-nosed girl.
Okay, everyone.
After some time passes, Monica calls out to the club room.
Why don't we share our poems now?
Before I know it, everything is back to normal. Everyone goes to retrieve their poems, and I do the same. I make eye contact with Monica, and she smiles at me. I wonder what she was talking about with Sayori.
Okay, poems.
Ba-da-ba. You still watching over there in the chat? I'm definitely not giving up on this game yet, but I'm running close to the end here. I've still got some time, but I don't want to do the whole rest of the time on this if nobody's fucking watching. I don't know. I know it's a slow build-up. And I can feel the anticipation mounting, but
I don't know, you guys.
I don't give up on a game just because it's slow. Still, you're sleeving some cards while you're watching? All right, let's keep her going. All right, Sayori needs it the most. Let's go get her. Hi, Sayori. Look at your little smile.
It's nice, I guess.
Come on, I can already tell you don't like it.
Well, you don't need to worry about what I think. After all, you wrote this for someone else, didn't you?
Oh, she knows, man. She knows.
You just gotta bring it up at this point. You gotta pull her aside and be like, look, I'm macking on Yuri. I can see you're thinking this. I need to clear the air with you. And I get it. If you're in school, like these, like, I assume high school, like, you're not mature enough to handle that shit. At least I wasn't. Some people might be, but if so, they're lucky.
You wrote this for someone else, didn't you? Probably Yuri.
Eh. I write this for anyone specifically.
Maybe. That's not really what I meant, though. But it's okay. You're making new friends just like I was hoping. Oh.
That's not boredom. That's just the air coming out of my fucking lungs. What kind of cards you sleeving over there?
It makes me really happy. And you're happy too, right? In this club?
Well, of course I am.
Good. That's all that matters to me. Thank you, DG.
Sayori, is there something wrong?
Huh? No, nothing. I'm just a little tired today.
Alright. Just tell me if you need anything. Yu-Gi-Oh! Not bad. I had a fair collection back in the day myself. I don't know where they went. I feel like I gave them to like a family member, like a cousin. But I had some good decks going. I don't remember the specifics, but like I had all the mainstays. I had the Blue Eyes, White Dragon, I had Exodia, all the pieces. Dark Magician, Red Eyes, Black Dragon. I still remember. It's still up in the noodle. Yeah, I collected the hell out of that, and I did Pokemon cards, too. And I'm talking when they first, like, I was part of the original wave of kids who were obsessed in the U.S. with it. In fact, I bought this the other day when I was looking for the Christmas shopping. I needed somebody who matched my orange theme, and he fits the bill. His name is Kingler, and he is my very, very best streaming buddy. I'm going to put him there.
I will. Don't worry about me, okay? You can go and play with everyone else now.
If you insist.
Yay! I'm gonna go home a little bit early today.
Sayori?
Tell Monica I wasn't feeling well, okay? I'll see you tomorrow.
Oh, she's really bummed out. You need to fucking go after her. For a second, she cheerfully walks out of the classroom humming to herself. I think I see where the depression
warning is coming in, man. I think I can see this happening. We're gonna have to confront her.
The old style cards. You've got the old one. You don't like the new stuff? No. I don't know much about it. I played up until the third generation. That was my cap. But I was obsessed. I was like always like I as a kid I was like, I'm gonna be an animator, an illustrator for Pokemon. I'm gonna come up with the new ones, and nothing is gonna distract me from that ever. And so I did. I'm actually the one who drew all the new Pokemon that you've seen. Actually, that wouldn't be very good, huh? Because you said you don't like it. Never mind. I hate it. I hate it. I've never seen it before, but I still hate it. Who should I show my poem to next? Yuri, of course, man. Yuri. Hi, Yuri. This is for you. DG. Oh, is she gonna fucking get mad at me? Is she gonna be like, I see your game. Fucking cool your jets. Nope. Your writing has only improved in the last few days. Every poem you've shown me has been nothing short of spectacular. You've never played a single Pokemon game! Are you kidding? You've got to. I mean, I don't know. They might not have aged well. But I was obsessed. I was obsessed with, Pokemon Yellow, Crystal, which was a gold and silver thing. I had gold too.
You know, it's the same fucking game.
Ruby, Sapphire, and Emerald, man. Favorite Pokemon? Oh, man, alright. What is my favorite Pokemon? Oh. I gotta think back. Hang on. Let's see. So I was always partial to the ones who were the unsung heroes of the roster. So like, who's my favorite? Hang on, I'm thinking. If we're gonna be basic, I did like Totodile. Totodile was good. But I also liked, I think it was the third or the second generation, there was a Pokemon called Shedinja, which was like, you evolved like this bug Pokemon, but if you did it in a certain way, with like a space free, the discarded, like shedded skin, like the shedded shell of the bug, was its own Pokemon. This like, I'm gonna fucking find it, hang on. I'm gonna find it. That's what I'm gonna do, hang on. I'll show it. Torkoal, that's a good one, man. Good choice. I remember Torkoal, the big turtle. It's been a long time, but that stuff sticks with you. Hang on, I'm getting there. Hang on, we're getting there. Alright, this, and then this. This, and then, oh fuck, it's gonna go away anyway. Hang on, alright. You like my generic background there? Hang on, I'm going somewhere with this. Okay, where did it go? I need to find it now. There he is, look at him. Shedinja. He is really cool. He is a cool boy. That's probably my favorite. That or Ariados, which was a spider. But Shedinja was up there for me. For certain. In fact, I'm gonna keep him here. I'm gonna keep him right here. Whoa, hold up. There we go. I'm gonna give him his own border. Look at this. Thanks to you, Shedinja is now a fixture of this stream. Hey! There we go. Now we're talking. Well, now I gotta name it? Okay, alright. Hang on. Let's see. We're gonna call him... I got it. Husky. Cause he's a husk. He's husky. Husky, you're joining us. Someone's gonna join the stream and be like, what the hell is that? But now it does not matter. Let's get the game back, shall we? This isn't gonna work, man. That blocks like 90% of the text. Actually, it hasn't blocked the text yet. Hang on. It showed up. Ah! I clicked the wrong screen. There we go. Never mind. I think we're okay. Good name? Ah, I'm chock full of them.
I'm a little envious, even. I don't think it ever came to me this naturally.
Yuri, that's the wrong way to put it.
This never did come naturally to me. But I've been able to improve so much thanks to you. You're really the example I was chasing after.
Is that so?
Yuri smiles gently to herself.
This feeling. I'm so glad I got the chance to share my writing. I never thought it would feel like this.
It's worth it. Even though I'm putting Sayori through hell, it's worth it.
I remember you mentioning that yesterday. I can't believe you're so good at something and you've never even shared it with anyone.
It's kind of a shame. Maybe, but it's not like I really had a choice.
What do you mean?
Well, Yuri smiles sadly. DG, during lunchtime, I eat by myself.
Oh, the music. Da da da. Da 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 da. She's pathetic now. No, I'm kidding, I'm kidding.
Poor Yuri. Nothing wrong with eating lunch by yourself. There's nothing wrong with alone time. But if you feel lonely, reach out.
That's the thing that I wish I'd known in school too, is that if you are anxious about something, you just do it. Just do it. Because there's virtually no consequence. within the confines of the law.
Did you know that?
Like if you're feeling anxious, like if you see a group of people you want to be friends with, but you're afraid to approach them, just do it. Just do it. Because what the worst case scenario, they say no, and it's just like, all right, screw them. But that's easy. It's easy looking back to have that perspective.
Anyway, it's a great time to find a quiet spot and do some reading. In fact, I always have some books with me. You could say I really enjoy reading. Well, that's one way to put it anyway, but books are so full of amazing and inspiring people. People you want to fall in love with, or people you just know would make a really good friend. Cheerful people who always put a smile on your face, or deep thinkers and problem solvers who discover the mysteries of life. So when you look at it that way, I'm surrounded by friends every day. You know? And those friends don't laugh at me. They don't tease me for spacing out all the time. They don't make fun of my body type.
What's wrong with your body type, man?
And, they don't hate me for acting like a know-it-all.
She does kind of act like a know-it-all, but it's okay. People say that about you?
I'm not a know-it-all, DG. It's the opposite. I don't know anything. I don't know how to talk to people. I don't know how to make people see me as normal. I don't even know how to make myself happy. I have all these feelings, and all I can do with them is read and write. But it wasn't until now that I started sharing it with you that I really understood what was missing all this time.
But I haven't really done anything, Yuri, except flirt with you and fucking pick words in a poem that sounded good to you.
No, that's wrong. Just being patient and respectful, that's really important to me. I know I'm a difficult person, DG. I speak too slowly. I second-guess myself all the time. I read too deeply into things, but every time, you've always treated me just like anyone else. It's so rare that I get comfortable with myself when I talk to others, but that's why every time I talk to you, I just feel really happy.
I see.
Well, I treat you how you deserve to be treated, Yuri, damn straight.
And if other people don't see them that way,
then screw them.
I mean, I joined this club hoping I'd make friends. And I'd say I've had at least one success, wouldn't you?
If you put it that way, yeah, we really are friends now, aren't we?
She just turned fucking, like, bright. I don't know much about anime, but that style, man, that disappearing of the facial features when they're shy. It's interesting. Yuri puts her head in her... For some reason, I read that as puts her head in her mouth. I was like, what? She puts her head in her hands.
Like this. But this time, she's smiling as she does it. What have I done? Why did that go away? There we go. Right-clicking makes it go away. You want to show me your poem?
Yeah, I do. Let me get it for you.
Oh shit, Ghost Under the Light Part 2. I don't want to read the whole thing. Wait. Turns my hair over to the amber girl bathing. That she did a poem like this earlier. In the distance, a blue-green light flickers. A lone figure crosses the path, silhouette obstructing the eerie glow. That's me. My heart pounds. The silhouette grows. Closer. 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 Ow.
That light is bright as hell.
I open my umbrella, casting a shadow to shield me from visibility, but I'm too late. He steps into the streetlight. I gasp and drop my umbrella. The light flickers. My heart pounds. He raises his arm. Time stops. The only indication of movement is the amber light flickering against his outstretched arm.
Oh, that fucks with the focus. Won't do that.
The flickering light is in rhythm with the pounding of my heart, teasing me for succumbing to this forbidden emotion. Have you ever heard of a ghost feeling warmth before? Giving up on understanding, I laugh. Understanding is overrated. I touch his hand. The flickering stops. Ghosts are blue-green. My heart is amber.
Oh, shoot! I've brought her out!
I've brought her out of her funk.
She's fucking... Look at her. Oh, my God. Look at the nervous tousling of the fucking hair.
We've done it. We've done it, boys. We're in. Instead of taking it from me, she looks away. Do you dislike it?
No, of course not. I just don't really know how I should respond.
Despite Yuri's poems usually being cryptic, it wasn't hard to figure out what this one was about.
I don't know if I'll be able to explain this one.
That's fine. I understand this one.
I'm sorry, I apologize.
Yuri's having an even harder time speaking than usual. Does this one mean a lot to you?
Yuri nods.
I'm not really good with words, but I'm happy that you shared it with me. So thank you. And I hope we keep spending time together.
Oh, shit.
There's no turning back now, boys. It's done. It's done. The deal is sealed. The deal done been sealed. Right, Husky? Despite my inability to make contact, I see a faint smile emerge on Yuri's lips. I once again try to hand the poem back to her. But instead, Yuri gently takes my hands and pushes them back towards me. I hesitate in response to her warm touch.
Oh my god. You can... The poem is...
Once again, Yuri fails to form a complete sentence. Once again, Yuri fails to form a complete sentence. Nods. You mean I can keep it? Yuri nods.
I'd love to.
Again, Yuri smiles faintly as if she doesn't want me to notice.
You always make me feel nice. You know, I'm not good with people, but I hope that I can return the favor sometimes.
Yeah, don't worry.
I think you do a good job.
Oh, God.
Yuri finally turns back towards me. I guess we should move on before Monica says something. But I'm sure we can talk again later.
Yeah, I'm sure we will.
And with that, Yuri timidly smiles at me, and I return to my seat so I can put her poem away.
Okay, we're taking a break. We're gonna be taking a break.
This is a lot of reading, man. This is outside of my realm of experience, to say the least. I'm invested, all right? I'm down. But yeah, this is my first visual novel, as it were.
We're gonna need a break. Is this how girls get guys? By acting like Yuri? Taking notes, by the way. No. Sutton tells me being able to form a complete sentence helps.
I mean, she's cute, and, like, the thing is, trying, like, you don't have to try too hard.
I know it's a dumb cliche, but, like, it's a cliche because it's true. If you just, like, chill and show you for who you are, like, the person who is going to come up and like you, the person who's going to speak up and like you, is the person who is going to have the chemistry with you. And trust me, I was not that way. I put up a lot of fronts early on, and I got into relationships that did not go well as a result. But yes, being able to form a complete sentence helps. Yuri is very much a character trope.
Oh no, man. In middle school, sure, being like cutesy and like shy, that's good. But you gotta be able to speak your mind. I have a hard time with that. I have a hard time like conveying in relationships that I'm like feeling it. You know, that's tricky. It's tricky. But just take that from old Tinderbox. Be yourself.
Now, let's put on a front for Monica and pretend we like her, huh?
Hi, DG! Have you thought about what you want to submit to perform at the festival?
Well, being in this club is one thing, performing in front of a bunch of people. I'll have to give it some more thought.
Okay, no pressure, but whatever you do, I'm sure it'll turn out great. It would also make me happy to see. Anyway, let's take a look at today's poem.
Sure. You don't have a hard time saying things? People don't like when you voice your opinion. Well, screw them too. Just like fucking character guy said to Yuri. If people don't like it when you speak your mind, then it's not worth it. I mean, obviously, like within reason, but like, you know, you should be able to say what's on your mind, and a good relationship partner. We'll do the same. Son, I had to learn the hard way as well.
I let Monica take the poem holding in my hands. Your style's gotten so refined, DG. Yuri's been teaching you a lot of things, hasn't she?
Well, I guess so.
Yeah, I've been noticing how much time... Alright, never mind. I guess we're out with Monica, too. I think I've heard her say more words these past couple days than she's talked the whole year. I'm not sure how you did it, but that's pretty impressive.
Well, she just needs some patience and a way to talk about all things in her heart and in her head, I guess. I'm still getting the hang of it myself.
You're certainly putting in a lot of effort. You must really like her. It's awfully suspicious, you know, spending time with her in the club room every day, reading that edgy novel with her.
Well, I just feel bad that she has a hard time socializing. Makes me want to make sure she doesn't spend all of her time alone. Besides, the novel isn't too bad either, you know.
All right, I get you. Just be careful, all right? I know that Yuri isn't used to opening herself up, so if something bad happens when she's vulnerable, then it could be really hard for her. Her books aren't a total escape from reality. They're just a bandage.
You say it like I'm gonna hurt her.
Sorry, I didn't really mean that. If anything, she might accidentally hurt herself. Anyway, I'll share my poem with you now, right?
All right. The lady who knows everything. It's poem time. Wait.
The Lady Who Knows Everything by Monica. The old tale tells of a lady who wandered the earth. The lady who knows everything. A beautiful lady who has found every answer, all meaning, all purpose, and all that was ever sought. And here I am. A feather. Lost adrift in the sky, victims of the currents of the wind. Day after day I search. I search with little hope, knowing legends don't exist. But when
I can't do this. When all else has failed me, when others have turned away, the legend is all that remains, the last dim star glimmering in the twilight sky. Till one day, the wind ceases to blow. I fall, and I fall and fall and fall even more. Gentle as a feather, a dry quill, expressionless. But a hand,
catches me between the thumb and a forefinger, the hand of a beautiful lady. I look at her eyes and find no end to her gaze. The lady who knows everything knows what I am thinking. Before I can speak, she responds in a hollow voice. I have found every answer, all of which amount to nothing. There is no meaning. There is no purpose. And we only seek the impossible. I'm not your legend. Your legend does not exist. And with a breath, she blows me back afloat, and I pick up a gust of wind.
Damn, this light is so bright. That was deep.
You know, I feel like learning and looking for answers are the sorts of things that give life meaning. Not to get too philosophical or anything, but it was kind of on my mind, so that's what I wrote about.
I see. I never really put much thought into it.
In a way, it's almost paradoxical. Because if we'd had all the answers, wouldn't the world start to lose its meaning?
You know, there's one thing I noticed. It seems like everyone in the club prefers writing about things that are more sad than happy, you bunch of fucking downers.
Jeez.
Debbie Downer.
Are you surprised? I mean, if everything was okay, we wouldn't really have anything to write about, would we? Humans aren't two-dimensional creatures. I think you'd know that better than anyone.
You mean one-dimensional?
Yeah, that! Anyway, here's Monica's writing tip of the day. Are you ever too shy to share your writing because you're afraid it's not that good? It can be really disheartening to get a lukewarm response to something you put so much into. But if you find other people who enjoy writing, then sharing becomes a whole lot easier. Because instead of just telling you that your writing is good or okay or bad, they'll want to focus more on everything that went into it and the things you can work on. It's much more encouraging that way, and it'll make you want to continue improving. It's almost like having your own little literature club, don't you think? That's my advice for today. Thanks for listening.
Alrighty. So we got Natsugi left, but I think I'm going to leave it here. I think we're gonna leave it here for today. Tomorrow's the mainstream day, so maybe I'll pick up some more. I do want to try... Actually, who knows? I might do Strictly this tomorrow. We'll see. We'll see what folks want. But tonight, at least, we're going to be cutting a... we're going to be calling this one a session. So I'm definitely invested in these characters, even though nothing's, like, happened necessarily. That was, like... That advice sucked. She's... I mean, like... I get it, I guess. Like, if you... Like you just said, if you don't like it when people voice your opinions, join the debate club. Join the debate club. There are people who are glad to take opinions and fucking offer rebuttals and this and that. That sort of deal, I get it. But yes, in actual mixed company, that is a bad idea. I'm not in disagreement on that one. But yes, I'm gonna go ahead and hit save here. Alright. So I'm gonna hit save, and with that we are coming to an end here. And no, not in school. You're correct. Not in school. That's another animal. And I think that's something this game is kind of touching on too, is how like everything's so much more clicky in school. Twitter's a nice place for it. There you go. Twitter is just grown-up school. It's just a grown-up like school playground. Which, by the way, I have one of those now too. DG Tinderbox. Twitter/DG Tinderbox. All one word. That's right. I threw a plug in there. I ain't ashamed. But yes, I'm going to be calling this one a stream. Hey, thank you for checking it out. I've had people popping in and out all day. Well, since I started. But, and a few of them came through. I do not have a Discord. That'll be coming next. I was thinking of getting, once I get a little bit more of a base here, base of followers going, most of them are when I do GeoGuessr. That's where everybody shows up. But, you know, I'm definitely gonna end up with a Discord in the very near future. For now, it's Twitter or YouTube. I have a YouTube as well, where I'm putting up any stream highlights and eventually VODs, but not yet. But yeah, we're gonna be cutting this one short. I'm still digging it. We're gonna get to this, whatever this twist is supposed to be, man. I know there's a twist, and I'm just waiting. I'm building up the anticipation here. But for now, we're gonna call it. Let's go. Say, thank you for watching. Thank everyone else for watching too.
Even if you're VOD watching right now, if you're watching this after the fact, thank you very much. If you ain't followed, I would appreciate a follow if you wanted to catch me Thursday, Saturdays at 7 p.m. EST. If not, that's cool too. Just drop by when you can, or don't if you don't like me. No, I appreciate it. And I hope you have a good night there, Animu. I hope everyone else watching has a good night as well. And this is going to be DG Tinderbox signing off. Have a doki doki evening. God, that was cheesy.